What's good? It's your boy, Jose Hustle. You're tuned in to Jose Hustle TV Season 3. I'd like to thank all my viewers, fans, followers, and subscribers for tuning in once again this week for me, Jose Hustle TV. Today's show, we will be discussing something very, very important. You know, everybody has experienced some part of this at some point in their life or some point while they've been using Twitter. How Twitter ruins relationships. So this is what I need y'all to do. Sit back, relax, get something to eat, get something to drink, and watch me. Don't watch TV, baby, because I'm about to drop some serious knowledge on y'all, some serious pointers and tips. So the first thing we're about to get into on how Twitter ruins relationships, putting smiley faces on a message sent to anybody other than your boyfriend or girlfriend. You know, that right there, it automatically raises questioning or eyebrows. Like, for one, who is this you sending these smiley faces to if you ain't sending them to me? You know what I'm saying? Smiley faces are a big deal over the internet or via text messaging, Twitter messaging, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Because smiley faces can mean many different things. You know what I'm saying? Like, they could mean, I want to have sex with you. I would like to have sex with you. It could be a way of showing heavy flirting. And then in some cases, it could mean nothing at all. But in most cases, the prior three I just stated are the ones that's being assumed, that's being used. You know what I'm saying? So be very careful when you're using those smiley faces. It could be a friend. It could be your boo. Be careful when you using this shit, because it will be taken out of proportion. It will cause some drama. It will cause all kinds of unnecessary stuff that could be avoided. You know what I'm saying? The smiley faces can get you in a lot of trouble. The second thing we're going to discuss on how Twitter ruins relationships, subtweeting. This is very, very, very frequent that happens. You know what I'm saying? Like, it usually starts when somebody is mad at somebody else that has a Twitter account, and it goes off and start talking crazy. You know what I'm saying? Talking about them, but not at them. My way of doing the subtweeting, I don't really take it at all, because, you know, if it's not at me, it's not at me. That's how I look at it. But, you know, it can get very ugly. You know, it can be a lot of business being spread all across the internet. You don't know which followers are tweet watching and all this good stuff. You know what I'm saying? And then 10 times out of 9, you know what I'm saying, the people subtweeting each other have each other's phone number. You know what I'm saying? Like, a relationship with a friendship or whatever. Like, oh, so you'll go to the mall and buy this, but you ain't gonna take me out to eat. You know what I'm saying? Instead of putting that shit on the internet, or you all in your avatar with this and that, but knowing you can't pay for your child support, instead of doing all of that, just call the person or text them or do whatever. That subtweeting can get ugly. It can make a 10-year friendship go down the drain within a fucking 5-minute tweet spree. You know what I'm saying? And the final thing that I'm going to discuss that ruins relationships via Twitter is not answering a text or a call. You know what I'm saying? But your steady tweet, that can grind a person's gears to the fullest extent. That will drive a person crazy. Like, seriously, that is the ultimate sign of disrespect. You can, most time, you're tweeting off a mobile device. You know what I'm saying? So you seeing that text message or call come in, but you're ignoring it and you're steady tweeting. I mean, it's like blatantly ignoring you. You know what I'm saying? That giving a person subject to flip out, and they will flip out. You know, to avoid all of that, just send back a text, say I'm busy or whatever. But I know a lot of people, relationships that went down the drain because of tweeting and text messages and calling and all of that. Don't let Twitter ruin a great thing you got going. I know a lot of people are in love and having great relationships or trying to build to it. Don't let Twitter get in the way of all of that. People, spread the love, have fun, do your thing, you know what I'm saying? But look, that's today's show. I am your host, Jose Hustle. I appreciate y'all tuning in. Let me give a couple quick shout-outs. Let me give a big shout-out to King of Fresh. They supplied you both with the clothing, you know what I'm saying? King of Fresh, many heartbreaks, but I remain fresh. Shout-out to my young homie, Jay Fields. Y'all go follow him, you know what I'm saying? Shout-out to 41, Frank Walker, with Minnesota Vikings. Memorial Day Mayhem is back in the ATL. Y'all stay tuned in, stay logged in for more details I'm giving y'all. Another thing, we got a big sneaker event. All my sneaker heads, all my shoe heads, all my OG heads, sneakers and speakers at Fat Caps. Me and T have linked up to do something real big and major in the city. Two L's on the cloud, smoking sex and all of that. So you think you got a sneaker collection, you bring it, because I'm going to have mine there. I'm going to put it on display, and shit, it's for sale, buy, trade, or whatever. So you got a shoe game, you bring it out there. You know what I'm saying? Self-made. Shout out to the Rose God, MVP Derrick Rose, Chicago Bulls. All my Bulls fans, y'all know what the deal is. We finna go get that 7 ring. And when we do it, I got something special for y'all. So everybody, we keep on rocking, keep on doing our thing. We give a big shout out to all my sports homies that hold me down. All American Auto, Anand Hazi, he in that draft this year. So let's hope that he gets, you know what I'm saying, he gets the opportunity to go show his talents in the NBA or anywhere else that's offered. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Jay Crutch. He doing his thing. He working hard. He in the gym. He getting to it. Shout out to G-Rob out of UGA getting to it, making it happen. I need you to be an All-American this year, big homie. Shout out to Jamie Graham doing big things. Shout out to Golden Tate. But look, that's today's show. I appreciate y'all tuning in. Jose Hustle. Watch me don't watch TV.